Hey everybody, Harry P. from the Driftless Homestead. Hey, today a lot of people always ask, I've had people pull over and want to buy this yard trailer, as people call it. It's a little more than that. This is a Corey Model 3000, so it's designed to hold, the running gear is designed to hold 3,000 pounds, which is quite robust. I tried to buy a second one, but Corey had raised their prices so much, I refused to pay it. And they ended up going out of business. So you can't buy these brand new anymore. But I did find another company that does make small running gear, 2,000-pound running gear. And I bought one. It's an Easy Trail from the Easy Trail company. And they said it's 2,000 pounds. It looks identical in how this one was made. So I'm sure that maybe this one overinflated what they can do, and maybe the Easy Trail people are selling themselves short. But the running gear itself was only $1,200 for a brand new running gear. I think that's cheap. You make your own decision. I'm in the market for some farm running gear, but they're much larger than this, and it would be hard to work those in the woods, where this is just as wide as the RTV, and I could take this anywhere the RTV will go. So I'm going to show you what you get for $1,200, and then we're going to continue on to show you the build on it, and hopefully it's something that you see might be beneficial. I know it's very beneficial for me. Maybe you'll find it beneficial for you as well. So stick around. Okay, so here's what you get for $1,200. You might know a welder that could make this, but you know, I'd rather pay the company $1,200 so it doesn't go out of business. So when I start buying more running gear, they're excuse me, they're around to support me. So you get the front axle, the rear axle, the tongue, and then you get the spacer bar that goes between the front and rear axle. So what that does, you see there's an adjustment on here, different holes, so you can adjust the length of what you want the running gear to be. Another added feature, which is on that piece there, and I'll show you after I put it together, is that the front and rear axles, not only does the front axle turn, but the middle bends a little bit and gives a little bit, which is important for when you're working in the woods and driving things around. So stay tuned, we're gonna do the assembly on it right now. Okay, so this is the rear axle for this. And what I had done was I brought this over to a welder guy and I had him weld this 2-inch receiver on here so that we can link the trailers up and hook them together. They tend to, because the front axle steers on them, when you link them together, they all go on a row in the exact same tire path as the RTV would. So this is all green, so I'm just gonna rattle can sprint it red to match. I don't know if it'll be an exact match, but red will be red in my eyes. So we're gonna do that. The other thing was on the tongue there, they tend to come with pin hinges to hook up to tractors, like mini tractors and stuff like that. So I had a guy install one of the 2-inch receivers on there. So this will be the lead trailer in my 2-trailer setup when I go back into the woods to get my bucked up rounds. We'll get spray painting this bad boy. Looks like a good match to me. Maybe I should have been a painter. We'll give that another coat after it dries. Okay. let's find out what size these are here. These are the lug nuts. They put them on, kind of painted them on, so I know I'm going to need a wrench to take them off. What is that? 7/8. Kind of tight there. There's a lot of paint on there, so the size isn't always the size when you paint them. So, oh, it backed out quite easy. Well, not easy enough to turn with the finger. I got all kinds of leverage on it here. It's a good thing they're red, then I'll be less likely to lose them in the grass that needs to be mowed. It's a shame there's only so many hours in a day, you know. That's one. So the rest will be in jackrabbit mode. Here's four. I'll go grab a tire. These tires were an upgrade. This is a, they're a flotation tire just like the other ones, maybe not quite as wide, but you know, with them only staying on pretty much on the dirt, you know, they don't wear down very much. You know, you see those running gear for farms, you know, the hay wagons or whatnot, you know, these things last forever. So when you're putting a tire on, make sure that you get the valve stem to the outside, or you could create yourself problems down the road. I'm not going to tighten them down because you want to make sure that you got everything lined up first. So it needs to be a little bit jiggly until everything is started. Thank you.
Lost my tools here. I'll wait before I do that. make it a little easier to stand it up.
Okay, there is our easy trail running gear put together. Once again, I had a welder add this receiver on here so I could join two trailers together. This is the running gear here. The nice thing about running gear is when you're fully loaded, because it's a four-wheel trailer, there's zero tongue weight on the tongue, so you can switch trailers around as you want or need to. Another thing about this, especially out here in hill country, because the roads can tend to be uneven, is the fact that here it's kind of hard to tell, but there's a this is actually bolted to this, which is bolted to this, and this piece runs somewhat free, not front to back, but side to side, and it helps you going over bumps, because if you watch this joint here, as I lift up this side of the trailer, you'll see that, you know, there is some, it's a little bit painted shut right now, but there is some rotation
that goes on. It'll go further once it breaks in, that goes on. So that's it. 2,000 pounds it'll hold. Real quick here. So it'll hold 2,000 pounds. The next thing I'm going to do to this is put the deck on it and sides on it. Hopefully you'll show up for that as well. And then you'll see both trailers bolted together, pulling logs, not logs, but pulling rounds out of the woods. Once again, I like to buck up my stuff out in the woods and leave that part of the mess out in the woods. And that way I only have to move the rounds. I don't have a tractor with a bucket, so that kind of helps me work on a larger, smaller scale, right? Because I'm able to, with the RTV, get back into the woods with the two trailers, bring back a lot of wood, but I don't use a tractor to drag logs out of the woods at could be random lengths, creating more cookies. But here, by bucking them out there, I guarantee myself that they're 16 inches. Then I just need to pick them up and put it on the trailer. So thanks for showing up today. Don't forget to hit that like button and hit that subscribe button so you can see me finish this trailer build with the deck and the sides. And I'll give you some more great ideas as far as that goes. So thanks for showing up today and have a great day.